Good day, everyone, and welcome back to TMac FPV, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. This is the third video in our micro FPV drone parts video transmitter series. If you missed the first two, no worries. A link will pop up in the upper right-hand corner of this video, so you can go ahead and check those out. Today, we're going to be looking at the EWRF e708. TM3 Pro, and I think they used TM for TMac, I'm not sure, video transmitter. We're going to be going over its features, checking out its power outputs with the Immersion RC RF power meter, and taking it out for some test flights on both its min and max powers, so that you can see the quality of its video. Previously, I'd never heard of the EWRF brand of video transmitters, so I asked the question from people who've used these video transmitters in the past, just how good are these? Here's what we found out.
My question was, does anybody have any experience using these transmitters, and if so, are they any good? Because it's got all of the features we're looking for at a reasonable price. I got a response from three different individuals saying, for this one, EWF products work really well. Yep, EWRF are good, and at that time, this individual only had an issue with the fact that his version was only RPSMA. And I believe both he and the individual below talking about the SMA and RPSMA connectors were referring to the model prior to the Pro version, which was the E708TM3. That particular model of this video transmitter did only have an RPSMA connector. When the Pro version came out, they replaced it with an MMCX connector and included an MMCX to either an SMA or an RPSMA cable in the package that you get with a video transmitter. So today we're reviewing the newest model, the E708TM3 Pro version with the MMCX connector. This individual says, best VTX he ever had was EWRF. Worked better with a cleaner image than Tramp or Unify for him. That's saying a lot to me about EWRF. Now I also searched for any additional YouTube video reviews, and this individual, Wojtek, has a couple videos up back from October and December of 2018, and he's had experience flying these with numerous other people simultaneously. So I asked Wojtek the question, has he had any problems with durability or the VTX overheating? Does it still work after these few months that he's had it? And his response to me was that he did not have any disturbing problems. There were no problems. And so far, he's made about 50 flights with it. He also wondered if it would overheat, but nothing like that ever happened. He also went on to state that a big plus of the VTX was that there were no disturbances in a group of six people flying simultaneously with 25 milliwatt power settings. He flew on race band 2, where his friends were right next to him on race band 1 and 3, and the other three people were on race band as well, and nobody experienced any type of mutual disturbance. I've put a link in our video description down below to Wojtek's video when he was flying in his group of six people with no mutual disturbances. If you're interested in that, you can go ahead and click on that in the link below. So based on the outstanding features of this video transmitter and the response I got from the individuals when I asked the questions, we're going to go ahead and test this thing out today and form our own opinion. Let's see how it works.
Before I forget, if after watching this video you're interested in this video transmitter, we've gone ahead and put links to it in the video description below for your convenience. It's coming in at 32.8 millimeters with the MMCX connector, 30 millimeters not including the MMCX connector, the width is 22 millimeters, and the height, I'm getting 3.9 millimeters, and it's weighing in at 4 grams.
These are its features compared with the previous two video transmitters that we reviewed so far in this series. This video transmitter has all of the features that we're actually looking for in a video transmitter for a micro FPV quadcopter. It's small in size and weight. It's got a max output power of 200 greater than or equal to 200 milliwatts. In fact, this particular video transmitter has got 800 milliwatts max output power, which is completely unbelievable. It has an audio input pad, which means that you can connect the audio line from the microphone in your FPV camera, if it has one, or better yet, at an external microphone, such as an electret microphone or a MEMS microphone, which have better audio than the microphone in your FPV camera, or if you had a microphone on your VTX. It's got the MMCX connector, and it actually has smart audio, which works. Of note, the model we're testing is the US version. It's a 37-channel version, which means frequencies 5645 megahertz, 5925 megahertz, and 5945 megahertz are blocked in the E-band. So this version, the US version, has all legal FCC authorized frequencies available to us with an 800 milliwatt max output power. It has A, B, E, F, and race bands, with the exception of those three frequency channels in E, E4, 7, and 8, which are 5645, 5925, and 5945. The reason I'm pointing this out is there are several versions of this video transmitter out there, some of which only go up to 500 milliwatts only, that's still quite a bit, and some of which have other frequency bands and channels in addition to the ones that are legally authorized by the FCC in the United States. We don't want those. The one we wanted was the one that only had the frequencies which are FCC authorized in the United States. Therefore, we got the US version, which does have those legal frequencies and an 800 milliwatt max output power. The bonus is that it's only $19.99, which is substantially less cost than the first video transmitter which we reviewed.
Okay, we're going to be using the same testing procedures as we did for the previous video transmitters in our series. We're going to test the various power levels or different power levels through the entire race band, channels 1 through 8, and also channel F4. For the sake of time, we're only going to show in this video the different power levels that we tested for race band 1 and also for channel F4. However, we will show the results for the entire race band. So for now, we're going to test race band 1, and on race band 1 at 25 milliwatts, we're getting 31 milliwatts. At 200 milliwatts, we're getting 192 milliwatts. At 500 milliwatts, we're getting 451 milliwatts. And at 800 milliwatts, we're getting 615 milliwatts. On channel F4 at 5800 megahertz, and our meter set at 5800 megahertz, on a setting of 25 milliwatts, we're getting 30.2 milliwatts. At a setting of 200, we're getting 197 milliwatts. At a setting of 500, we're getting 485 milliwatts, and at a setting of 800 milliwatts, we're getting 637 milliwatts, 635 milliwatts.
Okay, these are the overall results for all of the power levels, 25, 200, 500, and 800, for the entire race band 1 through 8, and also channel F4. As you can see, the power levels for the 25 and 200 milliwatt settings are extremely consistent. For the 25 milliwatt setting, it's consistently right around 30 milliwatts. For the 200 milliwatt setting, it's consistently between 195 and 200, just about. And for the 500 milliwatt settings, its lowest one was 451 and its highest was 514. For the 800 milliwatt settings, it fell a little bit short, but it was consistently above 600 and in between 600 and 700 milliwatts. Okay, for our test flights, we're going to be using the same field and the same flight path for all of the video transmitters that we review in our Micro FPV Drone Parts VTX series. The reason we're doing that is so that if you want to compare two or more video transmitters, all you have to do is open up separate windows for each one of the review videos of the video transmitters you want to compare, and then stack them one on top of the other, or side by side if you wish, and begin playing them simultaneously. And that way, although perhaps not perfectly synchronized, you'll be able to do a good comparison of one video transmitter to another because we're using the same flight paths, the same field, the same conditions, things of that nature. Okay, before we start our test flights, if you found this video useful, click on the thumbs up button below. Make sure and put your comments in the comments section below. We'd certainly appreciate your feedback. Remember to subscribe to your TMac FPV channel. We appreciate your time. Happy flying, and let's see what this VTX can do.